Hello everybody from TCT Asia. We are here in Shanghai, China, attending the largest Asian additive manufacturing show. 3D Natives has had the chance of exploring all the many interesting 3D printing applications. And in this video, we're going to be focusing on the five most interesting we saw, from aerospace to automotive and much, much more. Join us. So here we see something that outstands the aerospace industry. An integrated hypersonic aircraft presented here at the BLT booth, Bright Laser Technology, one of the largest Chinese metal manufacturers. This part was assembled post-printing and includes both topological and lattice structure frameworks. The part was printed in 384 hours using aluminium alloy. It is a true display of what next generation aerospace applications can look like. And here we see the We see the Aniso dog, Anisoprint's 3D printed dog. The legs have been 3D printed using PETG and continuous carbon fiber. Each leg took around 12 hours to print in the Composer Nova printer of Anisoprint. The continuous carbon fiber is used as an internal bone structure, helping with its overall structure and stability. Anisoprint here showcases yet another way of how 3D printing can contribute to industries such as automation and robotics. And now something for our motorhead friends, a fully 3D printed metal motorbike frame found here at the CNPC booth, a Canadian company with production facilities here in China, focusing on metal powders. This bike was produced using Scalm alloy, a high-performance aluminum alloy originally manufactured by AP Works, part of the Airbus group. Known for its high strength and corrosion resistance, this material is perfect for industries like automotive and aerospace, where lightweight yet durable components are essential. A fully 3D printed motorbike? Not something you see every day. Here we can see the Qinling Dragon God, created by the Chinese design studio StarForge in collaboration with R3D Filaments. This impressive artistic engineering piece consists of over 1,000 components printed with TPU and PETG in FDM 3D printing. But beyond its technical achievement, this piece immediately caught our eye because of its cultural significance. It reminds us of the traditional gods and mythical creatures deeply rooted in Chinese heritage. Our next application is an impeller 3D printed by E+3D, made completely by hard alloy copper. It took a total of 186 hours for this impeller to be 3D printed, and it's very impressive when you think that it was all done in copper. Copper, notoriously known to be a difficult material to process due to its high thermal conductivity, though E+3D has managed continuously to deal with such large-scale metal parts. And that's a wrap for our top applications of the show. Let us know, what did you think? Were you impressed? Were you less impressed? We would love to know. Let us know in the comments below. See you in the next one.